Well, the weekend is here, and that means it is time for our family-friendly movie reviews with Bob Waliszewski. He's the director of Focus on the Family's Entertainment Review Department called Plugged In Online. Well, Bob, there's a relatively unknown movie out right now. It is called The Book Thief. What's your take on that one?
You know, Ephraim, I like this movie. It's set in World War II, and it tells the fictitious story of an illiterate girl who's adopted by foster parents in World War II Nazi Germany. Mom's pretty harsh. Dad, however, is really kind. And he begins to teach her how to read and write. Next thing you know, they're at a Nazi book burning ceremony. And afterwards, she takes a book. She's not supposed to, but she takes it down in the basement and begins to read it. But that basement becomes a pretty important place for another reason. The foster family take in a sickly Jewish refugee when he knocks on their door in the dead of night. And that becomes more of the focus of this movie. Not books, not stealing books, but the going out on a limb for this Jewish man. Now, from a Christian perspective, we've seen this story in real life. I think of Corrie Ten Boom and many others who brought Jewish people into their homes at great risk to themselves. But that's the key reason why I really like this film. The idea that take a risk. There's nothing in it for you, but it's still the right thing to do. Family friendly, there's a little bit of war violence, quite mild actually. I gave this one a 3.5 out of 5 for family friendliness. Mm. And quite frankly, if there was a rating that was even a little higher, a 3.7 or 3.8, we don't have it. But if there was, this film would have gotten even a nudge higher. It's a very encouraging, inspiring movie. Not for younger kids, but for around 11 or 12 on up. Very, very worth considering.
Absolutely. Well, are there any other movies that are currently playing that may be family friendly?
You know, there's quite a bit right now. Now, there's no 5 out of 5s, and there rarely is. I have done a few of those over the years, but there's none. But there's some that have the potential. The number one movie in the nation, for instance, Thor, has potential for teens on up. Ender's Game, Free Birds, an animated film that we talked about a few weeks back. Bit weak, but something for the kids. All Is Lost, Robert Redford's movie, very little dialogue, also has some positive things. Captain Phillips, and even Gravity, which is still going strong in the theaters. So there's quite a bit right now.
All right, Bob, thanks. We'll see you next time.
Sounds good.